site. Please stand by channel 1.
Communication switching to channel 1.
All right, here it comes. Be ready.
Roger. Switch controls to manual override.
Awaiting confirmation of the video feed.
Countdown is running at 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
The Mikey Podcast.
Yo, and welcome back to the one and only award-winning Mikey Podcast. How the hell are you? God, it feels like it's been forever since I've done a show. It's been a week.
Yo, what's happening? It's Mikey. If you are interested in making a podcast, I cannot recommend Spotify for Podcasters enough. Dude, it is so freaking easy. Seriously, Spotify for Podcasters lets you create and then distribute your podcast, and you can even earn money from it, man. And you don't need any fancy equipment. Spotify for Podcasters lets you record and edit your podcast right from your phone or your computer, so no matter what your setup is like, you can just start creating today. And you can do video podcasts too, like I do. Just download the Spotify for Podcasters app or go to Spotify.com/podcasters to get started today.
It's been longer than a week, but we'll talk about that in a little bit. For those of you that are new here, this show is Wild Ride Through the News, true life stories, conspiracies, and so much more. If you are a member of the Sub Club, you can be watching this podcast instead of listening to it. If you're a freeloader, you can listen to it on all platforms, Spotify, Apple, iHeart, all of, name them. It's everywhere. So lucky you. Or you can get over to MikeyPodcast.com, join the Sub Club, and watch all the podcasts right there. Get the Sub Club Chronicle and all the good stuff, and support independent media, which is really the way to go. Join the Sub Club to keep this show rolling. Anyway, today's show is going to be a little different than normal shows because 22 years ago today, crazy shit was going on in America, and I want to talk about that. But first, I got to mention a few other things, and we'll get into the whole show real quick. First of all, round 4 of the Aftershock Mikey Podcast Festival Survival Kit is going on right now. If you want to win the tickets to Aftershock, the final pair of weekend passes that I have to Aftershock, if you want to win those and you want to win the survival kit to get you through the entire weekend, you're going to want to head over to the Mikey Podcast and I Am Mikey Instagram pages. Look for the round 4 Aftershock Festival pictures, the very first picture on the profiles. Follow the rules, which are very simple. And then wait until September 29th when on September 29th, I'm going to announce the final winner. I already got 3 other winners. Congratulations to you guys. You'll be partying over at Aftershock with me and a whole bunch of other people, a million other people. And then potentially you could be the very last person to make your way over to the Aftershock Festival, which is happening October, what, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th, 13th, 14th. It's like happening the entire month of October. I'm just kidding. It's not the entire month, but it's going to be a hell of a show. And I'm really looking forward to that. Also, this show is brought to you by my good friends over at Higher Elevation, higherelevation.com. Make sure you go see them, guys. Actually, you don't have to go see them. It's real easy. Just go to higherelevation.com. See if they deliver to you, which they probably do because they've expanded their delivery area. I'm talking about Citrus Heights, pretty much Sacramento, Roseville, Rockland, Granite Bay. They're like hitting up into Folsom now. They're everywhere. Carmichael, I believe they're everywhere. They're just getting bigger and bigger thanks to you guys. And I mean, I just appreciate their support more than I can just say here. So if you headed over to higherelevation.com, make sure you use promo code Mikey. I don't make any money on that. That just shows, hey, you know, I listen to the Mikey Podcast and they're like, oh, we like Mikey. You know what I mean? It doesn't give me any money, but it does save you 20%. So that's pretty dope too. I know I quickly mentioned this, but I'm going to run by it again real quick. These are like these things that I have to do at the beginning of the show. It is what it is. Just deal with it. MikeyPodcast.com or on Spotify, you can join the Sub Club. Couple different things for those of you that don't fully understand. If you are a member of the Sub Club on Spotify, totally great. Not a problem. I'm not complaining. You can stay there. It's okay. You get access to the videos. You get early access to the podcast, and it's great. If you're a member over at MikeyPodcast.com, same thing, but you have a couple different levels, where a couple different ways you could pay. You could pay 99 cents a week if you want to. You could pay $2.99 a month. You could pay, what is it, like $8 or something like that for 3 months, or $25 for the year. So you got a couple of different ways that you could pay there. You still get access to the videos, but it's only at MikeyPodcast.com. I don't have control over what Spotify does. So if you subscribe at MikeyPodcast.com, that's where you have to watch the podcast. You get it commercial free. You get the videos, you get all the good stuff. Other than that, you can listen to it everywhere, and there are commercials, but it is what it is. You can also subscribe to the free Mikey Report at MikeyPodcast.com. All these links, by the way, are in the description here, too. And the Mikey Report is just the weekly, semi-weekly newsletter. I usually every other week I send it out, but it will probably go up to weekly soon So that I'm really actually looking forward to that because I like doing the newsletter. It's a lot of fun. And I don't know. It's, I think it's kind of a good way for us to communicate and stuff. And I can give you an update on what's going on, any shows that you might have missed or whatever. So you can subscribe to that at monkeypodcast.com. Again, this is free. And by doing all these things, you are supporting independent media. You're supporting independent content creation. We're getting, trying to put an end to this corporate grip that mainstream media has on media in general. You know what I mean? Like, the, if you want really good content that isn't controlled by advertisers, that isn't controlled by some fucking asshole in an office who has no idea what it's like to even be a normal, regular human being, then you want to support content like this. And it doesn't have to just be me. Like, it could be whatever independent content creator you enjoy. I just support them in whatever way you can. And that's subscribing, sharing, liking, and in other ways on this particular show too. As I said, you could become a sub club member, but you can also just review this show. Just leave a little five-star, rate it. You know what I'm saying? Like, whatever platform you listen to the show on, you can rate it, you can review it. And those things help immensely. And I can't even tell you, like, it's ridiculous because it just, you know, it puts it in the feed for other people to see. So that's just a really great way to support not just the Mikey podcast, but any independent media content creator that you enjoy. So rate them, like them, share them, all that good stuff, because independent media is really the future of media in general. Because I'm telling you right now, if you're going to sit and follow corporate media, you're going to sit and you're going to follow, what is it, like NBC, ABC, whatever, you're just going to continue to get lied to. I promise you that. I have nothing to gain by lying to you. I just want to bring you the truth and the truth about those idiots. And I want to sell, you know, a couple of Mikey podcast mugs. The coffee tastes so good coming out of the Mikey podcast mug. Let me hold this up for you so you get another really good view. Look at that. Look at how pretty that mug is. That's good shit. And like I said, the coffee tastes better out of that mug. Oh, by the way, it's Monday. Monday does fucking suck. A couple other things real quick. Well, not really a couple things. One thing, I didn't do a show last week because I was in San Diego. And to answer your questions quickly, no, I'm not moving to San Diego. I would move to San Diego, but that's not why I went there. I went there for something else. Maybe I'll tell you later. Maybe I'll tell you some other day. I'm not going to tell you about it right now, but it was a great time. It was a lot of work. I was very, very busy the entire time. This was not a vacation trip for me. For those of you that are like, oh, well, he's hanging out over the Del Coronado. Blah, 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 must be making all kinds of money on a podcast. No, I'm not, by the way. I actually, it costs me money to do this podcast. So keep that in mind. This, any money that comes from this podcast goes right back into this podcast, and I have to pay out of my own pocket. So I'm not doing this for the money, folks. I'd like to be. That's where you come in and you can become a subscriber and we can make that happen. I can give you a show every single day. That's what I'd like to do. I know I've mentioned this before and I know you're like, get on with the fucking show. And I will here in a second. But like, I want to be able to do the Mikey podcast every day. I have ideas of ways to not just do the show during the day. You know, it's a daily show, but also daily content updates throughout the day, news updates and things like that. I have the ability to do it. I have the ways to do it. I have all the things that I need to do it, except for the funding, because without the funding, I have to like figure out other ways to make money. And that prevents me from being able to do this all day. So help out, join, become a sub club member, man. There's like a million people to listen to this show. If all of you just subscribe, just imagine what that could do. It could make the show really freaking great. But no, I wasn't in San Diego for me moving down there. I will tell you this though. I did get a job offer. I got a job offer in Texas and I have to turn it down. I not that I really want to. I would love to move to Texas, but my life is a little weird. You know, I was married before. I was married for like a few months. So I had a baby, you know, me and my ex-wife, we had a kid together. We were living on the East Coast at the time. And we had like moved to Boston and then we had a kid and then we moved to New York City. So it's just jobs that I had. And, says we were Sirius XM at the time. And we got married because, you know, for insurance purposes and all that stuff, all the bad reasons to get married, but we did it and it didn't last very long. It was a terrible idea. We were divorced less than a year later. And, it was a weird situation for me. Because I was put in a situation where my ex was like, I'm not staying here. I'm moving back to California. I'm taking our daughter. And the courts were like, we can't force her to stay. And I'm like, I get it. So I had to quit my, what at that time was my dream job, and move back to California because I wasn't going to give up that time with my daughter. My daughter needed me. And so I wanted to be there for her. Sorry, just like looking behind me, papers behind me that I should have put away, but whatever. So I had to move back to California, and I was lucky when I moved back to California, I was able to get my old job that I had, which was a radio job that I'm not at anymore, but I was able to kind of just be right on my feet. So it was great. But now I'm in a situation where I'm not doing what I'm supposed to be doing. Like I'm supposed to be on the radio of some sort, whether it's production, voiceover, whatever it is. That's what I'm supposed to be doing. Sorry. But I'm not. So I lost my radio job last November. For those, most of you know that. Sorry, I got to keep drinking a coffee because it's early. And so here we are. But I've been looking for new jobs, and I've been trying to find a job where I can do it from home so that I can continue to do the podcast and fund the podcast, since you're not. Fucking freeloaders. Yeah, I by the way, side note real quick, the reason why I bring it up all the time is because there's a lot of people that listen to this show that don't subscribe. I'm not trying to be an asshole or anything, but you're getting the show for free, which is great. You know, you're getting audio, and I appreciate you so much. You have no idea. Just listening to the show does help. It helps more if you're a subscriber. But I understand, man, times are tough, money is tight, fucking Bidenomics, whatever the fuck that guy. I get it. So that's why I still do the show, and I'm not going to stop doing the show, because I know that there's a lot of people that listen to it and appreciate it, and I appreciate you guys. So I think that in the end, it's going to pay off. Just a matter of time, I guess. But anyway, so I was offered a job in Texas, in a place in Texas that I would live in a heartbeat. If my situation was different at all, I would be telling you right now that I'm going to be moving to Texas. But my situation is not for that. I can't leave my daughter. My daughter won't come with me, even though she wants to live in Texas. But I'm not going to put that sort of thing on an 11-year-old. I'm like, oh, you want to pick mom or dad? I'm not going to fucking do that. That's insane. And I'm not going to leave her for not just because, obviously I want to have the relationship with my daughter, but there's really good reasons why I need to stick around and be there for her, and make sure that I want to make sure her mental health is where it needs to be. And I'm not going to dive in too much into this, but there's a lot going on. There's a lot of shit in my life that you may not even know about. And I'm not going to get into it, but.
Shipping can make or break a sale. So optimize how you ship your orders with ShipStation. They make it easy to automate and manage orders no matter how big your business grows. And they might even be able to help reduce shipping and warehouse costs. So optimize and keep up your momentum for growth with ShipStation. Sign up for your free 60-day trial now at ShipStation.com and use the code POD. That's ShipStation.com with the code POD.
This episode is brought to you by JLL. Get an insider view into the world of commercial real estate with JLL's podcast, Trends and Insights, The Future of Commercial Real Estate. Whether you're curious about making cities more sustainable, the evolution of office space, or AI opportunities, this podcast will help keep you a step ahead. Tune in for candid conversations with business leaders about the biggest trends impacting how we live, work, and play. Subscribe to Trends and Insights now at jll.com/podcast.
TIAA is on a mission. Why? Because 54% of Black Americans don't have enough savings to retire. So in collaboration with big name artists like Wyclef Jean, TIAA released Paper Right, new music inspiring a new financial future. With 100% of streaming sales going to a nonprofit that teaches students how to invest. Stream Paper Right now and help close the gap.
It's difficult to make some decisions in my life where I have to. Sometimes there's decisions I can't even make. The decisions are already made for me. And that's one of them. Like, I can't move away. I want to, but I can't. So anyway, I was offered a job in Texas. Houston, doing something I would love to be doing. It's not on the radio, but it's radio. It's the production side of radio. It's the imaging side, it's the creative side of radio. It's things I've won awards for. It's shit like that. And unfortunately I can't do that. So all I can say is I hope that the decisions that I'm making or being forced to make in a weird way, and what I'm doing here, it's not about hope, actually, is going to pay off. I know that it's going to. It's a matter of time and when, I don't know, but I know that it's going to. So anyway, by the way, that's all this just happened in the last week. I'm in San Diego doing something completely different. There's nothing to do with any of this stuff. And then I'm getting phone calls from people in Houston who are like, hey, you know, we want to kind of throw this, you know, what do you talk about money? We talk about this. There's a potential. Would you move here? Would you do that? But whatever. So that's kind of what's going on. It's good to get you guys caught up with what's happening in my life. I know I totally went all over the place talking about my divorce and shit like that. But yeah, but the divorce thing is like I was forced to move back here and I'm stuck here. So people are always like, because I complain about living in California and people are like, why don't you fucking move? Just get out of here then. Why the fuck are you there? Why don't you suck dick? Okay, it's not just easy to just pack your shit up and move and leave your family and leave your fucking life behind, you fucking idiots. Okay, I have a life here. It's not as easy as just picking up and going. I'm so tired of people saying that shit too. It's like, oh, just fucking move. How about you just fuck off? You don't even know what's going on in my life or anybody's life when you say something like that to somebody. Fucking people. I'm not going to complain about that. I've already gone on long enough. It's 9/11. Or it's 9/11 2023. And I want to talk about that for a little bit because it's 22 fucking years ago. Like I said, shit in America was crazy. And I feel like every year I take a little bit of time to kind of reminisce about what I was doing on that day. Like, what were you doing on that day? Where were you? A lot of you are pretty young right now. A lot of you are around my age, but a lot of you are really, really young and it probably were kids when this was going down. I mean, I was an adult, but I was still kind of a kid. Excuse me. So every year on 9/11, I like to just talk about what I was doing, but there's a little bit more I want to get into here. So on that day, like I had just woken up in the morning, I was living at my mom's house. I was like 22 years old, whatever. Just being an asshole. You know, just starting off in radio. That was like the beginning of my career. I was up. I didn't know what I was going to do that day. Usually the same thing I do every day. I wake up in the morning, I make coffee, I smoke a little bit of weed. And that's just kind of what I was doing. I was smoking weed. I was watching the news, did that every single day. I used to watch the Today Show with Matt Lauer and Katie Couric. And so that's what I did. I made my coffee. I packed a little tinfoil bowl at the time. Don't ask. When you're 22 years old, you're broke. You do what you could do. And I open my window and I turn on the TV and I'm smoking a little bit of weed and I'm watching the Today Show. And just as I, you know, as I'm sitting there looking at the news, it's like Katie Couric, I believe, and or one of them too, or Matt Lauer had just announced that a plane had just hit the World Trade Center. I was like, whoa, dude, what the fuck? Really? A fucking plane? And I, you know, I was like, I was just going to watch, you know, and it looked like a Cessna, you know what I mean? At the time, just like a small plane made hit the thing. That's what they were saying too. It's like, it's a small plane. It's so weird. And I couldn't believe at the time, like, how the fuck did a plane hit the building? But also, you know, it is a Cessna. So maybe it was just an accident. At least that's what I thought at the time. Maybe it was an accident or whatever. And then it went on. And I sat there watching them talk about this. And you see the smoke coming out of the building. And Matt Lauer saying whatever he says. And in the middle, in between Matt Lauer and Katie Couric is a TV. Or maybe it was like just a video screen on the screen of them. And they were talking about what was going on. And within like 10 minutes of them talking, a second plane hit. And I witnessed that on television live. My mouth dropped at that moment. And I was like, what the fuck? Was that another fucking plane? And then Matt Lauer was like, I think another plane just hit the World Trade Center. And I couldn't believe it. And it looked, it did. Like, what the fuck is going on here? At that moment in time, I was so confused at that moment. I remember getting, I'm just an early 20 year old kid, basically. drinking coffee, smoking a little bit of weed, just waking up. But I was like, is this real? Is this really fucking happening? Did are planes hitting? We got to be under attack. Something's got to be going on. This is not right. It's not one plane and then another are going to hit the fucking World Trade Center. There's not two people flying around Cessnas. Plus that second plane, as we saw, for those of you that saw it live, was not a fucking Cessna. That was a big ass plane. So time goes on throughout the day, throughout the morning, just a little bit longer. The next thing you know, there's another fucking plane. Then there's a plane that gets shot down in Pennsylvania. Well, they say that the plane was brought down by passengers in Pennsylvania. The conspiracy is it got shot down. I don't know. And then there's the Pentagon situation. And I mentioned, you know, the conspiracies, because there's a lot of them when it comes to this, you know. And they're fun to think about, I guess. Not fun, but it's interesting to me to know what the story is, what the government story is, and what the conspiracy story is. And somewhere in between the two is where the truth is. Because a lot of it doesn't make sense. You know what I mean? Here's what I mean. Here's what we're supposed to believe. On the morning of September 11, 2001, 19 men armed with box cutters, directed by a man on dialysis in a cave fortress halfway around the world using a satellite phone and a laptop, pulled off the most sophisticated penetration of the most heavily defended airspace in the world. We're supposed to believe that? Overpowering the passengers and the military combat trained pilots on four commercial aircraft before flying those planes wildly off course for over an hour without being noticed by anybody or approached by any single fighter interceptor? These 19 hijackers, devout religious fundamentalists who like to drink, snort cocaine, and live with pink-haired strippers, all of these things are facts that you can easily search up, managed to knock down three buildings with two planes in New York City. While in Washington, a pilot who couldn't even handle a single-engine Cessna was able to fly a 757 in an 8,000-foot descending 270-degree corkscrew turn to come exactly level with the ground, hitting the Pentagon in the budget analysis office where DOD staffers were working on the mystery of the $2.3 trillion the defense secretary, Donald Rumsfeld, had just announced was randomly missing from the Pentagon in a press conference the day before. Luckily, the news anchors knew exactly who did it within minutes. Political talking heads knew within hours, and the Bush administration knew within days. The evidence literally fell into the FBI's laps when they found passports among the rubble. Yes, passports, because the hijackers felt it necessary to have their passports on them. Weird if you think about it, though, because like the passports survived. They didn't burn. The jet fuel supposedly melts steel beams, not passports. That's normal. Sure. But for some reason, a bunch of crazy conspiracy theorists demanded an investigation into the greatest attack on American soil in history. How dare they wonder if this is what we're being told is true? Goddamn crazy conspiracy theorists. That investigation was delayed, underfunded, set up to fail, a conflict of interest, and a total cover-up from start to finish. It was based on testimony extracted through torture, the records of which were destroyed. It failed to even mention World Trade Center Building 7, Able Danger, which was a military special operation that identified the attackers long before the attack even happened. There's all this information, by the way, exists online. This is everything I'm saying is actual fact. PTEC, go ahead and Google it, which was a company that had an investor with ties to terrorist groups that funded the attackers. I'm talking about the report that came out. Doesn't mention any of this stuff. Okay. Cybele Edmonds, who was an FBI whistleblower, and the drills that were going on that day. Drills of hijacked airplanes being flown into skyscrapers that were happening at the exact same time we were being attacked. Why wasn't any of that mentioned in the report? That all seems very important. The 9/11 Commission was lied to by the Pentagon, as reported by the Washington Post on August 5th, 2006, lied to by the CIA under oath, lied to by the baby lizard Bush administration. Speaking of baby Bush, he and the buckshot little Dick Cheney testified, but we'll never know what they had to say. You want to know why? Because it was done in secret, off the record, not under oath, and behind closed doors. The commission didn't bother to look at who funded the attack because this is, quote, of little practical significance. What? You're trying to tell me the people who funded the attack on 9/11, not a big deal. Doesn't matter. Why would that not matter? I mean, I think it matters who's paying me. If someone's paying me to do something, it might matter. Like, let's just say, I don't know, I'll throw it out there. Maybe someone paid me $10,000 to go kill somebody. Wouldn't you want to know who fucking funded me? This doesn't make any sense, people. Little practical significance. Shut the hell up. The 9/11 Commission lied to the families of the people who died, and at the end deemed the whole thing a failure of imagination. What the fuck does that even mean? Well, I'll tell you. Because according to Baby Bush, I'm not talking about Daddy Bush. I'm talking about George W. Bush. According to Baby Bush, nobody in our government had envisioned anyone flying planes into buildings. Well, you know, except for maybe the Pentagon, FEMA, NORAD, and the NRO. All of them had military plans in place in case something like this happened. Oh, and then there was the Air Force, like I said, conducting drills of airplanes flying into buildings. But, you know, nobody in the government ever thought about that. No, this was all just a coincidence. I remember Abel Danger, that thing I just mentioned a second ago. Yeah. The CIA destroyed 2 terabytes of data on Abel Danger, the same operation that identified the terrorists before 9/11. So they already knew who the terrorists were and what they were planning on doing. They knew. But let's just destroy this information because who needs this? We don't need it. That doesn't mean anything. Fuck it. Shut it down. Destroy it. It's not going to matter. I don't get it. I really don't. But that's fine, okay? Because I'm sure it had nothing to do with this. Literally nothing. It's okay. It's fine. It's what we do. The SEC destroyed all the insider trader information that had come out before the attacks, but that's fine too and normal. Because destroying records of the largest SEC investigation in history is just part of what we do in America. That's how we keep records here in America. We destroy them. The FBI argued to keep all the records secret and from the public. And that's fine too, because why hide anything? FBI is like, we don't need to show anybody shit. Because why? Because we're the FBI and you can fuck off. And the FBI is super trustworthy. We know that. Especially over the past few years, we've learned so much more about the FBI and how they are literally just an extension of whatever fucking president is sitting in office. They're just the police of the president. Doesn't matter if what you're doing is legal or not. They're going to come and get you. If the president doesn't like you, you're going down. Now, Osama bin Laden, the supposed mastermind of all this, went around living from cave to cave, to house, where he was somehow able to avoid the most sophisticated tracking technology in history and continually have access to the internet, where he would upload video of himself, somehow he miraculously appeared to be younger and younger in each video. Very strange. And this all happened up until he was captured in a raid that wasn't recorded and then killed while he was unarmed. They then dumped the body in the ocean before telling anybody about it. Oh, and pretty much every single one of the special teams members involved in the raid that got Osama bin Laden have died or are in some sort of trouble with the law. That's weird. Everything I said is the story of 9/11 that they want us to believe. And you have to believe it. Don't ask questions. You're not allowed to ask questions. If you question it, what are you, a fucking racist? What are you, crazy or conspiracy theorist? What the fuck is wrong with you? A Holocaust denier? What do you, fucking hate puppies? You're not allowed to question that ever. You're not allowed to wonder how somehow passports survived. You're not allowed to wonder why some of this information was kept quiet, kept secret. We were not allowed to wonder why, how George Bush and Dick Cheney testified and they weren't under oath. And that and we'll never hear the testimony. You're not allowed to question that. Because if you do, you're crazy. You're a conspiracy theorist. 9/11 was not an inside job. It was done by some guy in a cave a billion miles away with a fucking laptop. How does he have internet access? I don't fucking know. The caves are hooked up with the internet nowadays. Dude, all caves have internet. I don't know. I'm just kidding. And that was a long time ago. There was no fucking way. So where was this guy getting this technology? Where was this guy getting, if this guy was getting anything? Where was he getting this? How was he able to create this attack from so far away and avoid our technology? It just, it's just so much that it's been going on for 22 fucking years. Okay, we're never going to get the actual truth. But I can tell you right now that when 9/11 happened, there was a reason for it. I've talked about false flags so many times on this show. And I'm not, 9/11 happened. It was real. Buildings fell. People died. I'm not saying that it was fake. I would never say that. But I am saying that I believe that there was a hidden motive behind 9/11. What came out of 9/11? Let's talk about that for a second. There's one big, huge piece of legislation that came from 9/11 that continues to basically get renewed year after year after year after year. And I'm talking about the Patriot Act. The Patriot Act basically gives the government the right to do anything they want if there's an emergency going on. That's obviously just me making it sound very, very simple. There's a lot more to it. But they have the right to listen to your phone calls. They have the right to arrest you and hold you without a warrant. They have the right to search your internet. They have the right to literally do anything they want to you if they deem that you might be a terrorist or that you could be a threat to the American way of life. All they got to say is, yeah, he's said some crazy, they could take me from the things that I've said on my podcast and label me a domestic terrorist just based on the things I've said. I've never fucking did anything. I've never physically done anything, but the fact that maybe I've shown up at a protest, or the fact that I'm telling you that we need a revolution, or the fact that I'm saying that things have to change in America in order for us to survive, or our country is going to completely collapse. These things that I'm saying right now, that stuff, that could be considered domestic terrorist speak, whatever the fuck. And I probably already am on a list of being a domestic terrorist. So because of that, they can tap my phone. They can get into my computer. They can come into my house and take my shit. They can arrest me. They can follow me. They can do whatever the fuck they want to in the name of the Patriot Act, because they threw this little word terrorist next to my name. They can question you every single time you fly, which, by the way, I will tell you this, that almost every single fucking time I fly, I get harassed. I did not surprisingly get harassed when I flew to San Diego and back. But when I say harassed, it was like all of a sudden, like for whatever reason, some fucking TSA agent will walk up to me and start talking to me in line, asking me a million questions or whatever. This happens all the time. And then I go through fucking security and they're like, oh, there's something in your bag. No, there's fucking not. There's nothing in my fucking bag. Well, we got to go through it. You got to take your fucking pants off. We got to stick our fingers up your ass. No, it's never happened to me. I'm just kidding. But I'm surprised. I'm just telling you, though, this is, so to me, that makes me feel like I'm on some fucking list. I don't know that I am, but it feels like it when I get harassed every fucking time I go to fly. But what I'm telling you is that you listening to this type of shit, if you have the same types of theories and thoughts, or you just question things like I do, you're a fucking terrorist. And because you're a fucking terrorist, the Patriot Act allows them to do whatever they want. So I'm not saying that they knocked down two buildings and killed almost 3,000 people so that they can create legislation in order to allow them to do whatever the fuck they want. But I am saying is that when this did happen, somebody said, oh shit, never let a good tragedy go to waste. Let's create the Patriot Act. And I honestly don't believe that the Patriot Act was all of a sudden created. I'm pretty sure they had it sitting there waiting for the perfect opportunity to be implemented. And I love the name of the Patriot Act. Oh, the Patriot Act. It sounds fucking great. It's the Patriot Act. You're a patriot. Really, all it is just the government taking away your fucking rights. So that's 9/11 in a nutshell. There's a lot more to it, obviously. But the fact is that 19 hijackers from who barely could fly a fucking plane ended up with the worst attack in American history. I'm pretty sure my whole thing just froze up. So I don't know. If you heard any of that. Maybe you did. Maybe you didn't. I'm just telling you, false flags are real. And there's usually a reason when things like this happen. Sorry, I just got distracted because the whole fucking thing froze up on me. I've been having tech problems the past couple weeks, and I don't understand why. Like, all my equipment is on point. I think it's just the internet. Or it's because of what I'm talking about. And these fucking assholes are listening, and they're fucking up my shit. I don't know, man. I have no idea. But it's 9/11 today. And I want you to take today and even this week and think about how far we've come from then to now and how much has changed in the world. Because it's completely different. Something has happened from then to now where so much in our lives is fucked up. Right? Maybe I'm crazy. I don't know. It just seems like things just continuously get worse. Nothing is getting better. Brandon's not doing a good fucking job as a president. Okay? He's not. Anybody who thinks that he is fucking delusional and being gaslit. Our economy is not getting better. It's not. Obama was not a good president. He just wasn't. George Bush is a fucking murderer. Like, I mean, how the fuck from 9/11 to right now do we continue to allow this shit to go on? What are we doing? We're just talking about it. That's all we ever do. We just get online and we make memes and complain about it. Then you get a small group of people on January 6th who decide they want to fucking do something about it. Bigger than a small group. And they show up on the Capitol and they start. And next thing you know, these people are going to jail for 30 fucking years. For attempting to overthrow the government. Let me tell you right now. I'm not saying I agree with what happened on January 6th, but it was completely blown out of proportion, okay? And the truth is out there, and you're more than welcome to dive into the actual truth and not what the fucking media is telling you with their spin on the whole goddamn thing. January 6th was a crock of shit, okay? And what I was going to say is that we have every fucking right to overthrow our government. There, if you are somebody who thinks that things are good right now and thinks that the Brandon administration is doing a good job and our government is looking out for our best interest, you're a fucking idiot and you need to wake up. Because you got fucking 80-some-year-old motherfuckers running this country. Literally no possible way, 80-some-year-old multimillionaires, close to billionaires running this country. There's no possible way they could have any idea what it's like to be an actual regular fucking American. Nancy Pelosi, who's been in Congress for a billion fucking years, is going to run again? Get the fuck out of here. These people are so far removed and so disconnected from reality that they think we're stupid. The problem is they're right. Most of us are fucking stupid. Most of us are too lazy, too caught up in our own lives to give a shit. But that's what they want. They want us to be lazy. They want us to be overwhelmed with work and bills and kids and trying to figure out how we're going to put gas in the car and how we're going to get food on the table. And all those things are so much more important, no fucking doubt. But if we don't do something, if we don't change the way things are, those things that you're worried about right now, yeah, they suck, but you're not even going to be able to worry about them because your life is going to be completely in shambles. I don't think people really fully realize where we're headed. And we're headed down a very dark path right now. You know, we're on the verge of becoming just like China. I'm gonna leave it at that. It's Monday.
Monday fucking sucks.
It does fucking suck. It's 9/11. Just try to remember the people that died. For what? What did they die for? Nothing. Not freedom. Because America goes around spreading democracy all over the world. And if we were actually attacked by terrorists because of what we do and who we are as a country, then maybe we should stop spreading democracy. Maybe we should pull back a little bit and fix the democracy right here in our own country. Maybe isolationism is not a bad idea a little bit. Maybe America first is what we need to do. I gotta go. I'll be back on Wednesday with a regular Mikey podcast. This was just a show that I wanted to do today because it's 9/11. And I just want people to understand that we're fucked. Have a good day.